all of our favorites are vada pav, maybe even dabeli, shave pav. But here, this restaurant is taking your favorite ladi pav to another level. So, let's check it out.
This place provides you with four options. Basically, they are veg pav, non-veg pav, veg plates and non-veg plates. Okay, so we have started with the non-veg pav. We have ordered butter chicken pav and it has butter chicken inside it with curd and basil chutney, basil, okay, and they have given us bobby or fryams, but I prefer calling them bobby. So let's have it and see how it is. Boom. It's messy. And sab niche gir raha hai. I feel like it has a butter chicken-y taste, but also at the same time there is, you know, there's curd in it. So it kind of give you this masala pav kind of taste a little bit, but it has butter chicken. I'm just repeating, but still is there. And I feel like the side of fryams or bobby is like, it is kind of matching. It is a new concept with a very desi twist to it.
So for the vegetarian option of their signature dish, we are having the tandoori sriracha mushroom pav. Now they have this tandoori mushroom, and on top of that they have the hung curd dipping, and on top they have the fried onions, and they serve it with fryams. So let's check it out. So in a bite of this pav, you get the pav and you can also taste the spicy sriracha sauce and the tandoori mushroom. Oh my god, it's cooked so well. And it tastes different with the pav because you never have a tandoori mushroom with a pav. And the caramel dipping gives it another level taste. And they've definitely made it more desi by putting the tandoori mushroom in it. So this one's a good thing to try if you like spicier food.
Okay. Now that we have had the pav dishes, both the pav dishes, the vegetarian and non-vegetarian one, it is time to have one of the not pav veggies or non-pav veggies. And because Deepshika is here, we had to order the vegetarian one, that is Veggie Wonder. Okay, so what do we have in Veggie Wonder? Let's see. We have tuna paneer and they have given a sauce for it. Then we have the curd, basil curd dip. Okay, then we have paneer and cheese. It is very soft, sponge like and mushy mushy. Okay, then we have mushroom shammi kebab. We have mushroom shammi kebab and they have served with some fried onions. So we ate the entire thing and this is how I feel about it. Okay, the bhuna paneer was, sorry, paneer was soft and the sauce that is given went very well with it. Then the kebab, the shammi kebab, was a bit dry, but again it had a very powerful mushroomy taste in kebab. The paneer and cheese, the paneer and cheese was so soft, it melted in your mouth. In all, when you combine all those things with the fried onions, it was out of the box. It was so damn good.
So, for the final verdict of Packer Pav, we can weigh the pros and cons. The pros are that it's a self-service place, so you have to take it yourself and throw your own garbage. Secondly, they have different tawas for veg and non-veg, so you know they're not mixing it. It is very hygienic, they have gloves on. And coming to the food, it is very flavorful and it is different than anything you'll ever have around here in Pune. And the pav dishes itself is something I've never had before. But on the con side, it is a bit expensive, though I would really ask you guys to come here and try it because it's definitely worth it. So if you like this review, please don't forget to subscribe to Kulcha, like, comment and share it with a friend who might like to try it. And if you guys try it out, let us know in the comments below. Don't forget to follow us on all our socials. Okay, bye!